everyone, and welcome to the Source Talk Show. My name is Michelle Velasquez, and with me today is...
Hi, everyone. It's Tamika Tomlinson. We're glad to have you. We have a great program in store for you, so stick around and check it out.
All right. But before we even get into the program and what we're going to do today, we have some very special guests. And before we invite those guests in, we're going to pray and invite the presence of the Lord. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, come before us, be in the midst of us, and help us to learn more about your love and service, the importance of service in our community. Thank you so much for giving us a heart that we can share and help each other along the way. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. All right, so as you all can see, this week we're going to be talking about our community, about serving, and about also healthy lifestyle, because we're going to touch on a health fair that took place just this week in the New England area. So yeah. Who do we have coming on, Michelle? Who are our special guests today?
A special guest today are the ACTS Ministries. They have been around the Boston area serving in this area for some time now. So we are excited to hear about their ministry and how God has impacted lives through them. So let's bring everybody in. Welcome, ACTS Ministry. Who are we inviting in first, Tamika?
So we're going to hear from Andre Mercury.
All right, Andre. We're so happy to have you on the Source Talk Show today. Please tell us who you are and what you do in ACTS Ministries.
Well, my name is Andrew Mercury. I'm one of the team members, actually the communication leader. And for the ACTS Ministry, what I do is that a lot of communication between the businesses, the fire department, and other agency. I make communication with them. And also, too, in terms of if they need people, we need to get to these different agency, I usually forward it on to whoever needs to write out those letters. And I make sure that these in these other agency get these letters, review them, and approve all the different donations and stuff like that.
Awesome.
All right. And the next person we're going to bring in is Kenneth Mercury.
Good afternoon, everyone. And it's a pleasure to be on the Source Talk Show with Tamika, Andre, and Michelle. You know, I'm glad to be here. Look forward to this conversation.
Awesome. So tell us a little bit about yourself, Kenneth. What do you do? What was your role in ACTS Ministry?
Okay, sure. So currently, if you ask what I do, I'm an assistant professor at Oakwood University. That's what I currently do. However, in regard to ACTS, one of the things, I think around 2013, 2014, around there, basically it was just fulfilling, now I call it a vision I had, you know. I'm big on basically, and I tell students, I tell everyone I come into contact with, is really doing whatever God challenged me to do. I'm just huge in that, and it continues, and apart from that, in regard to setting up the organization, getting everyone involved, reaching out to actually the individuals who were in my dream, you know, that was a story of itself. And, you know, just to see how God is transitioning everything right now. And, you know, it continues because there's the other part of it to other area. And currently where I am, you know, I'm just laying the groundwork for ACTS to be here in the Huntsville community, Alabama community. Yeah. So, yeah.
Nice. So you're talking about expanding the ministry.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. That's a part of it.
Awesome. Yeah. Awesome. So we're going to pull in the other two individuals. We have Ashley Atkinson.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for having me.
Hi, Ashley. Welcome. Please share a little bit about who you are, what you do, and your position in ACTS Ministry.
Okay, so I guess I'm the newest addition to the team, I can say, right? but I fill in wherever I can mostly. I work with the communications to send out letters, to liaison with individuals to get things going. If you need me, you can see me on the ground moving all the time. I'm just up and about. So wherever I can work, they just put Ashley there and she'll get it done, basically.
All right, sounds good. So you're there rolling up your sleeves and getting ready to work. Yeah. Awesome. Last but not least, we have Tamar.
I'm Tamar, and I have been with ACTS from the beginning. And I have been privileged to work with all of our team leaders. And I have served as the secretary for ACTS, in addition, the health coordinator for ACTS Ministries.
Awesome. Welcome to the source. We're happy to have you guys here.
Excuse me, there's a message for you.
Thank you so much.
Welcome. So, Kenneth, you were talking a little bit about a vision that God gave you. Can you tell us just a little bit, as briefly as you can, what that vision entailed, and how did ACTS Ministries on a whole, how did this vision first begin?
Okay, I'll try to make that in maybe 2 minutes. Quickly, you know, basically what it was, it was like a Friday evening preparing for Sabbath. It was the second time I had this dream. I saw it before, and I remember I used to be asking the elders at my church, listen, we had a huge event in this community. And they will say, Elder, we never had anything like that. And the second time I had the dream, basically the message that came in it was, Kenneth, what you saw in the dream, it did not happen, but it is something that need to happen. And that was kind of the word I get. But what was strange, within that dream, the second time, I saw five individuals. One of the individuals I saw was my brother. I saw someone who was our musician at that time. His name was Max. I saw another person. And I've been, for name purposes, you know, I saw five person, but most of all, I saw the district pastor. I saw Tamika. Tamika was one of those persons I saw in the dream. And to make a long story short, before I called the district pastor, because I saw him, that Sabbath morning, I was trying to get him, and I say, you know what? I did not call one other person, and I called Tamika. That was the last person on the list. And I remember she telling me that Sabbath morning, you know, I saw you calling, and I did not go to pick up the phone, but something told me, pick that phone up right now. And with sharing it with her, she shared with me she had something similar, likewise to that a few years ago, but it never happened. And that was, for me, the change, because now when I called the district pastor, the first, before I was calling him, I just did not know what I was going to tell him. But after I heard what Tamika shared with me, I'm like, okay, Kenneth, this thing is bigger than you right now. But the thing about it, when I called the district pastor, he said this to me, say, Elder, I know exactly what you're talking about. We tried to do it the year before, and it did not happen. And he said to me, let's make it a reality. And that was like the marching word. And from that, everything started to get being put into place. You know, we started meeting. Believe it, it was building an organization from the ground up. And it was a lot of work. I can tell you, there are team members on this group. We met for a whole year, every week for a whole year. Every week for a whole year, we met. That's how intense it was just to get this up, and to God be the glory today. That's what I'll share.
Beautiful, beautiful testimony, guys. So can you guys explain, can someone explain to me, what exactly does ACTS stand for? ACTS. Please share a little bit. What does it stand for?
So ACTS stands for Adventist Sharing Christ Teachings Through Service. So yes.
So Andre's turning around, showing the back of his team. All right, that's beautiful. And do you guys function within the churches in the local churches in this area, or is this separate?
Right. So that's good, because the whole thing about it with ACTS, it's not about the conference, because on our team it was the area youth. So which means both at, on our team, there's both Southern New England, because we know we have two major conferences in this, in the New England territory. So there's both Southern New England and Northeastern working together. And that's the beauty of it. And what we do, we work as much as possible along with the pastor. I truly believe in this statement. If you want to go fast, you can go alone. But if you really want to go far, you got to go together. So, and for me, the best way we can go far is working with the pastors. We get them involved. We let them know what's happening. And from day one, the district pastor, the other pastors have been involved with everything we do.
And I just wanted to add, we're talking about the name of the organization. I remember literally that name was God Breath, because I remember going through a real kind of struggle spiritually. And I remember God just saying, I need you to do a homeless ministry. And that homeless ministry is going to be ACTS, because it's acts of kindness. And the name is Adventist Sharing Christ Teachings Through Service. And yeah. So when we came together, it was only fitting that become the name. And so not only, and you know, did we do evangelism, but we also serviced our homeless members as well. So that's another part of the ministry. So I wanted to segue in. Can you share, Andre, what has ACTS been doing over the years? Because I mean, I know, but can you share with the audience some of the things that we've been doing over the last 5 years?
You know, when we started ACTS, is that, and I want us to pay attention to something, is that anybody who is willing to be used by God, I'm not saying ACTS ministry, but anyone who is willing to use by God, we will accept you with out of a heartbeat. Because you know what I've learned in the past, and Ashley, all of us, we all can testify about it, is that no one person have the answer. There are multiple different skills. So mind skill set is different from Ashley's skill set. Ashley's skill set is different from Thomas' skill set. And what we have realized is that, looking at all the different skill set, I realized that we are building an organization for the kingdom. For the past couple of months, we have been at Four Corners lifting up the name of Jesus. And not only young and old, but everyone who feel fit, who come on that site, we realize that no one leave there the same way they enter on that compound. And that is something powerful that I want to share. Also, what we have been doing is that we have been praying for the community. Well, I know Tamika is here, and I know Tamika, she prayed. Ashley, she came in, she did what she had to do. She sang with other groups. And each one of us have that role. And you know what? And I'm glad that, you know, that we all can come together, because if we as people, or we as believers, come together, each one of us can move mountains. And that is good. And that is what Jesus' role was. He wanted to move barriers. So we are here in the community. We are still at Four Corners. I'm going to leave it open for any other person who want to comment.
All right.
Yeah.
Nice, Andre.
Yeah, and I know you all said what have been. So start in 2016, when we first launched everything, we had a major event at Harambee Park in Dorchester. And that was like the ultimate of a whole year's work of getting that event off the ground. And behind the scenes, so many things happened up to the very last moment. Even for the tent, we were still wondering how this tent situation would have worked out. And when we have seen God work in so many mysterious ways, and for us that was sort of a high moment, when the company, out of their good faith, they say, you know what, we're gonna drop the tent for you, even though we have not received the payment, you know. And I remember being on that phone call. I did not believe what I heard, but I was just so excited to pass the news on that the tent was coming. But God is good, and over the years we have just seen how God has blessed. So year two, we had another tent event. That same year we did a homeless drive. Normally we are done at by Melinia Castier, doing a homeless drive. We are working through the churches, and for the, I think what the past 2 years, therefore, at the Four Corners location, doing a evangelistic series community outreach, which a different flavor. You know, it's not continuous, but just utilizing the weekends where we can still deliver the same message. Anyone else can share? Yeah.
Kenneth, if you could tell our audience, because they may not even know the size of the tent that you're talking about, like, you know, so give more details on that for them.
Oh, sure. I'm trying to remember that the size of that tent, I think it was like 100 by 40, 100 feet by 40 feet. And even that was a prayer situation. I know I tumor because thinking about the first time, what sort of tent we can get, and it was tumor reading the Bible. When I tell you, sometimes God can provide answers for you from different means. Tomorrow she was reading that same week, she was reading the Bible, and I think it mentioned something like enlarge your territory or tent, something. So, and she said, listen, let's go for the largest tent we can get, you know. And all these things were just how I saw God moving behind the scene has challenged me in my life up to this day to just step out into the unknown. So that was a life changer for me. And this is what I encourage individuals, again, just doing whatever God has commanded you to do.
Yeah. Amen.
It's amazing what God can do when you are willing and ready and available to serve. Amen. You know, I remember when you guys started this initiative, and would you say it's about 5-6 years now since you've been doing this every year? Mm-hmm. Okay. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Yes.
Wow. God is amazing. And I'm so happy that you guys have made yourself available just to be a vessel for help and encouragement and just spreading the word of hope to people everywhere. You know, I'm so happy that you're here sharing this testimony and story.
And it's not just, you know, we mentioned homeless and we're evangelizing to adults, but I have to say that it's a well-rounded program. We have youths, kids, children, VBS programs going on. We're focusing on the elderly as well. So every aspect that we can touch on in any way that we can help anybody, we're literally trying to spread that gospel as wide and as far as possible beyond reach.
Yeah. Yep.
Amen.
Tamar, you wanna tell us? So it sounds like we have two aspects where we have the Ignite initiatives that happened, you know, in the beginning stage, but now we're at Four Corners. Can you tell us a little bit over the years as the secretary? So you should probably have most of the records. How many individuals do you think we have impacted? And I know this, we can't put a number on it because sometimes you don't know who you've impacted, but based on what you've collected so far.
So I can put a number on it, as you would say, but I remember like each year we would maybe reach over 1,000 people each year. So we've been going, 5-6 years now? So it's been over maybe 6,000 people. And one thing that, as Ashley mentioned about ACTS Ministries, we do not focus on any group, or to say we're reaching any group. We believe that everybody, God wants us to reach everyone. So whether you're homeless, whether you're working, you're a child, you're elderly, that's what our mission is. And our mission is found in Matthew 28 verse 19, which says, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And so, you know, we're reaching every nation, every kindred, every people, and so that's our purpose of ministry.
Just to add on that, you know, while we are impacting the community, we are also impacting the government agency also too, because if we do something right, every single year that we are doing this event, just for the listeners who are out there, is that from the Boston Fire Department, they have been contributing a lot. Public Works,
we are speaking about the health department. So as Ashley and Tom and they are mentioning all this different thing, we are not only impacting our own organization, not only impacting our community, but we are also impacting the government agency. And what I've learned over the years, and we all have learned over the year, is that they are willing to put their money where they see that is being used, not just to glorify ourselves, but also to build up a community. We can't leave out Stop and Shop. We can't leave out Target. We can't leave out Trader Joe. All the front Walmart. We can't leave out none of these organizations because each one of them played a very important part. Now, let me just share something with you all. Is that as we look at these organizations, they are also so eager to volunteer not only their time, their funds, but also their words of advice. So just today, while I was leaving, my boss was asking, he said, Andrew, what do you all have for this weekend? What does that tell me? Is that he's away and he's anxious. So I just happened to say, you know what? I need you to come by at Four Corners so you can see what is happening. So listen, we are impacting lives. And if you are willing, that is the approach. If you are willing to make a change, feel free. Reach out to any one of us and we're going to find your gift. We're going to find your talent and we're going to put it to use, right, Michelle?
I love it. I love it. I love it. You know, okay, let's come to this year. It's 2021. We're in the middle of a pandemic and you guys are out at Four Corners serving in the middle of a pandemic. Nope, that's not going to stop you. Now, tell me a little bit about what you guys have been doing this summer. Starting from, you know, just talk a little bit about your program, your evangelistic series, and the health fair.
Well, I'm going to mention that when you come on site, every single person are in their own different roles. There is because we are using different mics, there is a group that once one person is finished speaking on one mic, that person is in charge to make sure and sanitize that mic. There are individuals who are wearing masks. We have Tamika, we have Ashley, who is on the media, where we just recently welcomed the host, which is Mr. Barrett. And he has been doing a marvelous job. I can't express what he have been doing in the community. And we have the different pastors who are coming on and who are ministering. We have one of the hosts who have been blessing up with song, which is Michelle. So we are tapping into the all different resources. And also too, is that we got to also give thanks to the owner. I'm not going to say his name, but the owner have opened up his place. And he has said, Andre, you know what? This is your property. Understand what I just said. He said, this is your property. Whatever you all want to do with this property, it's on you all. Yeah, guess why I mentioned that? Because someone came and complained and said, Andrew, you all know, a senior citizen, he said, the stage is too high. So I look at the stage and I say, but wait now, but I can climb up there, not realizing I'm way younger than this elderly person. And I went to my dad. I said, Dad, this elderly person said the stage is too high. So I went to the owner. I said, sir, the stage is too high. He responded back to me. I said, well, Andre, isn't you the one who built the stage? So he said, you all can fix it. You all do whatever you want. So what we take up in our mind is that while I was on vacation, I received a picture with a step right next to the stage. So we are seeing that, listen, we are impacting life and people are willing to come on board and do the work of God.
So we've been having evangelism outreach, and also let's talk about this health fair that happened this past weekend. Do you have any testimonies that came out of that event?
Let me start here. You know, up to the week before, you know, we had a situation. Again, this is, we're talking about God behind the scenes, working on behalf, you know. Because like, during the Saturday before, I called Andre and I said, Andre, are we covered with everything? And there were still some things outstanding to get. And, You know, that evening, well, my mom, she came on the phone with us, and we decided to do one thing because it's like, you know, this is for the community. And we prayed that Saturday, the Saturday before, because we needed certain things to get to, at least to make sure what we promised the community, we'll have it. My friend, I'm telling you, God answers prayer by the Wednesday, because I continued to pray by the Wednesday. You know, I called my family because I wanted to know where are we right now in regards to getting all of the commodities, the supplies. And God worked in such a miraculous way that it was provided by the Wednesday to relieve that burden. So sometimes we may wonder about certain things, and God already have what he's going to do. And it's all that we have to step out in faith. That's just a background into the buildup, but so much went into it. I'll allow Ashley and Tamar, since Tamar was working on the health, give some background into other things that took place.
Now, okay. I had an opportunity to come by the health fair, and I saw a lot going on. I mean, it was just a lot of people, a lot of stalls and groups and tents. And I noticed Temperance at the top of one tent. I noticed a banner that said water and sunlight. Can you guys tell us a little bit more about why that was? What did that represent in the health fair?
Part of our Seventh Adventist message is what we call the health message. There is what you call the blue zone. Dan Buettner, he went around the world and tried to find like the longest living people. So the blue zones are considered to be regions where people live the longest. And so as Seventh Adventists, we do have what we call some health practices that we follow. We call them the 8 laws of health. And individuals within the blue zone, particularly the one that is found, the only one found in the United States, Loma Linda, Seventh Adventists actually do follow those 8 principles. And the blue zone, individuals within Loma Linda follow those 8 principles as well. And research has shown that they have lived 10 years longer than the average American. So as a part of our health message at Seventh Adventist, we do practice what you call the New Start. And New Start stands for nutrition, exercise, water, sunlight, temperance, air, rest, and trust in God. So for our health fair, as the coordinator and working along with our team, we decided that we did not want or attendees to get overwhelmed. So what we did was to coordinate the booths according to the New Start health principle. And so individuals were able to go from the different booths with getting information, in particularly about the 8 principles of health. And a lot of individuals were really impacted by it because it also helps to bring across what we call preventative health. And we actually try our best to educate our community on how to ensure that, you know, they can have a higher chance of living longer. Not that it's gonna allow you to live longer, but you have a higher chance of living longer following preventative health. So we were able to sectionize the booths according to our New Start.
So we're going to see a little clip from the health fair. My creator, Lord, you know my times. Seasons of breakthrough, my seasons of trials. So I will seek you, and you I will find. Now you make me stronger. Oh, come on. Oh, say, you
my focus. No, I know who I am.
Sing that song.
I used to run from battles, but you made me strong.
Jesus,
God strong and mighty. Woo! I am that I am. Help me, sir. You make me stronger. Anybody could have been dead, oh, but you're still here.
So welcome back. And anyone else would like to share a little bit more about what happened at the health fair? Because I saw, I also saw some people getting massages. I saw exercises happening. I saw people getting their blood pressure taken. Like, you know, this was all offered to the community for free?
Yep. So it was all free. All you needed to do was just register at the front with the registration booth. And in addition to that, it wasn't only a health fair, but it was also a back to school program for the school, for the youth in the community. So youth could come by, their parents could come by, and they were able to pick up pre-packed packages with books, pencils, erasers, sharpeners, whatever it is that they would need for back to school. And what was so awesome is that we were able to get these supplies donated to us from Staples. Some came from, I want to say, Andre's boss was instrumental in all that. But in addition to all that, too, we had Waymark coming in, and they brought some STEM supplies. They brought some back to school supplies as well. And we were able to distribute over 200 back to school supplies for the community. So really getting our feet on the ground.
Amazing.
And what what I like also too is that everyone who went to the health fair, at the end of the health fair, a lot of different individuals did not want to leave the compound because there was a lot of information that was given out to the community, which was very good information. Even the person who was there was cooking, live demonstration cooking on the stage itself.
Yes. Right. I also wanted to add, like, you know, Michelle, you did mention you saw massages going on. We did have two companies that came in, organizations that came in, the Relax Now Massage and the 3R Massage Group that came in to give free massages to our community. We also had the Sportsman Tennis Center. They came in, they gave out COVID care packages. And we also had representatives from the Dana-Farber Cancer Prevention Program, Karen Burns-White. We are so thankful that, you know, we had community organizations. We had the Boston Fire Department coming in, Royal Habits that came in. So there were several different community organizations that came in to be a part of the initiative and to, you know, just give back to the community. We also had two representatives that stopped by and let us know that they were so thankful for what they were seeing happening in the community. I believe they are actually running for Boston City Council offices at the moment, and we had two of those representatives that stopped by to just encourage us as an organization that they were so grateful that we're giving back. One of the testimonies also was that a lot of the business owners that was in and around the area, they actually also came to the health fair. They were so thankful. They were so grateful for what we were doing and reaching the community. Reaching them according to their needs. And that's what Christ wants us to do, not just to speak to people, but to also just meet the needs of individuals and bid them come to Him. So we're so thankful for all our volunteers, our exhibitors, or booth coordinators. We all came on board. We met several weeks. Just every week we were on meetings, making sure we gave the best towards to our community. And for all our volunteer staff and sponsors, we are so very grateful for what they have done. We also had a skills training. So we were learning about the lost arts, the lost skills of carpentry and woodworking and
electrical.
Andre can talk more about that. Yeah, so it was really impactful, and I was so blessed. And one of the things that I remember, like, once you entered within that health fair, everyone, there was just this joy that was on that compound. Like, you know, God put a joy upon the compound. And everyone who entered, they were so grateful and thankful. Eric Johnson, Nick Sinclair, Eric really kept us going. He kept us on our feet. He was our MC, you know, keeping us, giving out prizes, working along with our registration officials, Ashley and Carol, to give out as many gifts to our community members as well.
Wow. It seemed like there was a lot going on that day. And you know what? I am so upset that I missed the cooking demonstration. I think we should show a clip of the cooking demonstration. I know that they were cooking some healthy food. Can you share with me an experience, anybody, of somebody who came to the program, to the event, and asked for prayer, asked for Bible studies? Did you have those experiences during the summer initiative?
Yes, many, 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 many. You know, as we're going out, sometimes we have to rush out and, like, actually go check the camera. And as, you know, you're passing by, you see somebody standing up and you're just like, hi, how are you tonight? You know, just trying to talk with them. And there is this one person in particular. His name is Brother Joel. Yes. He told me to call me Brother Joel. And I'm like, all right, Brother Joel. Brother Joel came the first few nights and he was just looking and the singing grabbed him. I think Jasmine was singing at the time. And he was just so happy. And then the sermon touched him and he came back at night and he would come back after work. And he would be there every Saturday night. And I decided, you know what, let me give you a Bible. I'm going to give you a Bible. We're going to even give you a little card to sign up. And he said that he wants to get studies and he wants to do that. And every day he comes, every time he sees me, he's like, Sister Ashley, the Bible is perfect. And I've been reading it and I love the book of Psalms. And he goes on and on. And there's just some people passing by and they're like, what's happening here? And you just like, all right, let me give you a book. Let me give you a flyer. Come back. And they come back and they're touched. They're truly touched. Even persons passing by, they're driving by, they will be playing their music. They turn it down so that they can hear while they stop. I'm telling you, it's amazing what's happening. The businesses have been touched. They come out. They try to give their support, monetary, whatever way they can. It's really a blessing what's been happening in their community.
Amen. I also wanted to add for the health fair as well. So one of the eight health principles, trust. We believe in holistic health, and we believe that your spiritual health can also have a great impact on your holistic health. And so we had that trust booth, and at that booth we had some booth coordinators. They were responsible for, you know, connecting with the community, talking with them, you know, finding out how they were doing in terms of their health, spiritual health. And one of the individuals that was at that booth mentioned that the experience they had, so many people were just asking for Bibles. So many people were just so willing to take the spiritual books and to read it. And so many people were asking for prayer. So we know there's a need. People are hurting right now, especially with COVID and so many things that's going on, you know, dealing with anxiety, dealing with, you know, just sickness and just so much. You know, so there are a lot of people who are in need, and they were so grasping, you know, asking for prayer at that booth. And that shows us that there's so much more that needs to be done in terms of, you know, we need more volunteers to help to reach as many people, because we know there are people who are hurting, who are in pain right now. And we were able to connect with some of those individuals who entered into the health fair and who have been attending the Friday and Saturday afternoon meetings. So we were so thankful for that opportunity.
Awesome. You know, as we getting ready to wrap up at Four Corners, there was some experience that also there was one experience that this little girl was, I think maybe couple house down on Washington Street, was listening, hearing this music through her window. And she went to her grandmother and said, "Granny, what is happening at Four Corners? Why are we not there?" And this young girl picked up and she ended up walking out through the house, pulling her grandmother to Four Corners. Now, while she was pulling her grandmother to Four Corners, my dad was at the corner of Four Corners, and my dad tried to speak to this young lady and the grandmother, and the grandmother passed my dad and paid him no mind. And let me show you how the Holy Spirit works. I was in the audio room and I happened to say, "Ashley, you all, I'm going to go outside." And I went outside and I happened to just walk by my father. And I saw this young girl and a grandmother, and I stand up next to her and I asked her, I said, "Miss, how can I help you?" Now this grandmother turned to me and she started to share some experience to me. And I was looking up to her and I said, "Wait, Lord, did you send me here to listen to this lady concern?" And while I'm sitting there, the young girl turned to me and she said, "You know, I like what I'm hearing." And I want us to pay attention to something, is that while the grandmother was speaking to me, the grandmother turned to me and she said, "Who are the individuals running this event?" And you know, the Holy Spirit said, "You know, it's some youths and young adults who is running this event." And she said, "Wait, can my granddaughter be a part of it?" I said, "Is she willing to be you?" If you realize, I'm using that word a lot because God is looking for individuals who are willing to be used. Not only that, is that right next to this lady, there was another lady with a next chat. Listening to what I was sharing with this lady, and she started to cry. And at that point, I turned to my mom and said, "Mom, can you go and listen to why is this lady crying?" And she's crying because the other young child had a problem. And at that minute, I said, "You know what?" I asked the lady, "Can you hold on until after we finish the whole program, and I will speak to you right after?" Now, I would have believed that this lady would have ended up leaving, but this lady ended up staying because the granddaughter would not have leave. So I went back to the tent area and I spoke to the person who was ministering to the community. And I said, "I need you to make an altar call appeal for someone who need prayer." And he went up, and the last song that he sang, it touched that heart. And when the speaker made that appeal, the mother and the young, I can't remember if it's a boy or girl, went up and they requested prayer. Now, we believe as people, we believe that prayer changes things. And if you know that you need prayer, don't let this opportunity pass you by. Make sure you are there at 6:30 and reach out to anyone who you see that you can speak to. Reach out to any one of them and say, "You know what? I heard the news broadcast. I heard the message on the SOAR program, but I need some prayer." And what also catches is that even the business owners reach out and they all wanted prayers. So it tells us that there is something happening that you also, each one of us, need to be involved. And I'm going to share it again. If you are willing to be used, God is going to use you.
Amen. There's lots of work to do. Amen. And God is calling each of us to be his disciples. Amen.
Yes.
Thank you so much for all the testimonies, for, you know, stopping by to share with us. And, you know, just tell us a little bit more about ACTS Ministries and what's happening in the area. So if someone wants to get involved in ACTS Ministries, how do they get involved? And also just share with us, I believe tonight is the last night of the program. Yes?
Yes.
Tonight, Saturday, is the last night of the program. So yes. Tell us what's happening tonight, and then tell us how if you're willing, like you said, Andre, how can individuals get involved in this ministry?
Now, Tamika, just to let you all know, I received a call, right, from the owner. And he said, Andre, Saturday is the last night, right? And the statement was, what if the community wants you all to go an extra 2 or 3 weeks? You don't have the energy. I know we all are laughing, but that's a question that we all have to make a decision, because as I mentioned as we started broadcasting, not one person is doing the work, it's a whole group. So I mentioned to him, I said, listen, I can't make that decision. I gotta speak to every single person who's taking a part from the setting up to the breaking down, because it's a labor. You know, the Bible text, and I'm not going to tell you where it's taken from, all those who are listening and who would like to go and search the scripture. What I'm going to do, I'm going to do a challenge. Is that okay? Host, can I do a challenge? If
go ahead.
If a visitor find this text and come to Four Corners and find anyone with an ACTS t-shirt or anyone on site and said, I was able to locate the text. Now, the Bible uses a statement, which is a true statement. It said that the harvest is
ripe.
But the what?
The labor of the field.
If you can find that text and come on site and give it to any one of us, we're going to have a prize for you. I'm not going to tell you what the price is, but we're going to have a prize for that individual. So back to the statement. If you need to, if you want to know where you can get information, the fastest way right now is to meet us at Four Corners. We're going to be there from 6 to 9, and following that, you can ask all the questions. You can be on board, or you can send an email to ACTSBoston@gmail.com, or you can go to the website at ACTSBoston.org, and there's a section that you can do, register, give your name, your telephone number, and one of the team members gladly reach out to you and we'll get you working for the Lord. So understand this, if you sign up, that means that you are telling us that you are willing to be used by God.
You know, guys, there is a text in the Bible that says, beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news.
Mercy.
Romans 10:14.
Amen.
Beautiful are the feet. And that's what you guys are doing. You guys have beautiful feet right now.
Amen. You're
allowing God to use you to do and to act in ways that are positive and uplifting to those around you and those in need. And that's what Four Corners needed this summer.
Right.
And I'm just grateful that you guys have allowed yourself and to be available. And for those of you who are listening that will join this team and will make themselves available, we are thanking God for you in advance as you allow God to help, to use you to help others to learn about the good news. Thank you guys for joining us on The Source, Andre, Kenneth, Ashley, and Tamar. And I know Tamika is very much a part of this team. Even though.
Yeah.
So we are thanking you all for joining us on The Source Talk Show. And we hope to have you back again to share some more experiences that you've had as you continue in your ministry. If you guys would like to share any last minute, anyone, feel free to jump in and then we can close out.
I'd like to say to our audience that God put us on this earth for a purpose, and especially for those who, you know, believe in God, He has a special work for you to do, and no one else can do that work. And so even if you're not a part of ACTS Ministry, you know, just pray and ask God, what is it you have called me to do at this time in Earth's history? What is it that God wants you to do? He has given all of us different skills, different talents, and there are people that I'm going to be able to meet or reach to that you may not be able to. And there are people you're going to be able to reach that I'm not going to be able to. And so if you are listening right now you know, get involved. People are out there who are in need, and you know, you can turn on the news and you see so much need in this world. And so God, that's what God wants of us, just to be the hands and feet of Jesus. And so just encouraging everyone, whether it be via social media or just doing something, you know, on the grounds, whatever it is, through your job, whatever it is, God has called you. So just answer his call.
So I want to thank this all for hosting us. You either have to tune in on the source or you have to tune into the ACTS website. If you look, ACTSBoston.org, or you can call us, you can email us at ACTSBoston@gmail.com in order for you to get all the updates, all the information, all the pictures of what have done in the past. You need to tap into one of the resources so that you can be uplifted and you can be encouraged. You can even bring your family members, your friends, whoever. Bring them aboard. We're not going to turn on anybody. If you want to be a part of a ministry, the quote I'm going to leave you all with so that it can stick in your head is that if you are willing to be used by God, we are ready to accept you if you're ready to be used by God.
And that's an excellent note to end on. We are so grateful that you could all stop by and be with us and continue to work for the Lord and continue to be vessels for his cause.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Bye. I just want to say a special thank you to the ACTS Ministries for joining us on The Source today and for sharing their beautiful testimonies of how God used them and how God is using them to change lives.
So we're going to leave with you the cocaine video of what happened at the health fair with ACTS Ministries. So you can go ahead and check it out at the end of this video.
We also want to say thank you to our viewers for joining us, and we hope that you were encouraged by their testimonies. And we hope to see you again on the Source Talk Show, where God is who we
look to. Bye-bye.
Diced tomato. She's going to make salt fish, cod fish, vegetarian cod fish.
So my salt fish, in this meal that we're making today, we don't have no animal products, no meat, right? This fish is what we are going to use in that real salt fish. This is the heart of a palm. The palm tree heart. So that is what I'm going to use instead of the saltfish. But this palm tree heart, we have to take it and we have to soak it overnight in a little salt and in some seaweed, some dry seaweed or baked seaweed. We soak it in there and we cut it up just as we do with the saltfish. So as you see, it's going to be very tasty. It's going to be very tasty and very nice, easy to make. So here we go.
She's going to add what?
Sweet peppers.
Chopped.
Right here. We have that. So we have some scallion.
Now she's adding some scallion. It's basically, this is how we do our codfish home. South. Now she's adding some garlic. Some thyme. Now these things are freshly grown in her garden. So we're getting organic stuff here today.
I like to plant, you know. I like to plant, so you see, so we have all these things from my garden. Well, not the garlic, right? But the honey and the tomato, the scallion, the chives, and all those is from my garden. I don't have a big garden. It's very small, but I make space for everything. So this is my catfish. This is the farm. I want to show you. So I'm going to show it right now. This is organic sliced palm. Yeah. So that's the way it is. They have sometimes some that's long and bigger than the two. But this one is sliced. This is the organic one. But all of them is organic. So we're going to stir this a little more just to get everything incorporated. Okay. So here is my ACTS. So the ACTS, what you do, you get it out of the can, you rinse it off, and put it, throw the boiling water on it and drink it, and here is the ACTS, well washed. Regular seasoning. More thyme. I love thyme. And I love garlic. So I'm going to put a little more garlic because garlic is good for us, especially in these days that so much things are going around. So as you see the texture, it's not the same texture as the salt fish. So Sister Annie's recipe this evening is quinoa, rice and peas. Quinoa, rice and peas. Instead of rice and peas, rice, she's going to use quinoa. But it's the same procedure as with the rice, with the regular rice. So right here in her pot, she has her beans, which is cooked. She has her scratch garlic pepper for the flavor. You know the flavor of Caribbean flavor. That cover of space. So, you have to have it there. We're not going to break it. We're just going to make the beans boil with it. Coconut. And she have her coconut milk in there. She have her beans. She have her thyme. And she just give it now a little stir there to try to boil and to put in our quinoa in there.
This should be boiled
okay.
Already.
As we know that quinoa, scientifically it is known as quinopodium. That is it. Scientifically named. Quinoa is like a cereal grain. It's a crunchy texture and a nutty flavor. The husks have different color of quinoa. They have the pink one, they have the cream one, they have the black one. And each one of them have a identical taste. Quinoa seed is flat, oval. They're usually light yellow. It can be boiled, it can be added to salad, they can take it and make porridge, they can take it and make, put it in cereal, they can take it and sprout it and make quinoa flour. And it also, when it's sprouted, it can use as, put it in the bake as and use as like popcorn too. Quinoa as so here Sister Hans, she's putting on the pot to boil now. It may take about 15 to 20 minutes of the if it has the right amount of one. That's right, right?
Yeah.
15 to 20 minutes. The quinoa cook very fast, very much faster than the rice. The nutritional value of quinoa, they have the calorie for 100 milligrams is a 120 calories. It has less calories than the regular rice. It has protein, it has sugar, it has fiber, it has fat,
Lord, you said it in this. So if you're trying to lose weight, you can use your quinoa instead of rice. And it's for you, it's very pretty because you have a lot of fiber.
Some people like when they're frying red planting to have their planting cover over their eyes. Sister Han now is frying her planting, but she has a red planting. Okay, my next dish, what I'm going to make, I'm going to do my fried breadfruit, do my callaloo, and incorporate my codfish.
The ackee and saltfish, Lord of mercy, man, I tell you. Let me tell you something, it smell good, it look good. I am just waiting to taste it for you all the way from Trinidad and Costa Rica, that we fly these people specially to make this food and stuff here. I am waiting, I'm waiting, I'm waiting.
Out of the farm. So to continue my recipe, I am doing my breadfruit. So what I'm doing, I'm frying my breadfruit. I'm frying the breadfruit right now. So I'm going to make up my dish, and after I finish frying the breadfruit, I'm going to go ahead with my callaloo. I have my callaloo. Wow. My dish is complete. My dish is made up of saltfish and hackley, breadfruit, callaloo, fried plantain. And so just let me finish my dish and I go right over to the callaloo. Sister Anne is going to continue with the recipe now.
Okay, for my batter for the sticky chicken, cauliflower, I made a batter. It's 1 cup, 1 cup of flour, a pinch of paprika, a pinch of cayenne pepper, like a quarter teaspoon, 1/8 teaspoon, oil, half of the yellow seasoning. That is to give it the color. And I mix it with like a 4 ounces of water, so that gives me the batter. I will dip the cauliflower into the batter and fry it, and then I have the sauce. The sauce is a little bit of ketchup, like a quarter cup of ketchup, and some buffalo chicken sauce with some onion powder in and garlic. So that is going to be the sauce.
This is my the flour from the cauliflower. This will make the cauliflower. I'm going to dip the cauliflower into the batter. Then I'll breadcrumb it. I'll use some breadcrumbs and then we fry. It's after cooking. When it's stir frying, we get stir fried. Like we have to start with a quarter cup of water. And we just keep adding like a tablespoon of water to stir fry. You don't have to use either, if you want, that's your choice. Use oil. But to fry, we just have to fry our breadfruit. That's the Caribbean style. That's what makes it so tasty and fabulous. And delicious there. So I'm going to look for my callaloo. Incorporate my callaloo to my dish with my breadfruit. Incorporate my codfish. I incorporate my fried plantain, and this recipe would be finished.
As we can see, the color is starting to change. The color is starting to change now. It's turning that nice, nice brown color. And when she finishes, we're going to add our sauce on it. And oh my God, it's going to be very nice.
This can eat, you don't have to eat with rice and peas. You can also have it with
like chips. You can have it like a dip, to make a dip, a bacalao dip, and you have it there to eat. It can be a snack, but I think it's a healthy snack. And the next thing what you want to know, you don't have to fry. You can put it in your dip, set it up on a tray, and put it in the oven, which is much easier, because you don't have to stand around the stove to turn it, and much healthier. We didn't have a oven out here, but this is very, 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 very good. Get it in the oven, you put it for about 25 minutes, and you're always ready to go.
Almost finished here.